Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us see all about concurrency. So concurrency can occur at four stages or four levels, guys. At machine instruction level, high level language statement level, or unit level, or program level. So because there are no language issues in instructions and program level concurrency, they are not addressed here, guys. So only basic. Okay, just give me a second, guys. Okay. Only basically the concurrency means multiple processors within an operating system, guys, which is nothing but multi-threading. Multi-threading within a process. Yeah, that's what I have just written here. So, having multiple processors within a single OS is what we call as concurrency, guys. So, it is basically of two types majorly. So, types of concurrency, two types, physical concurrency. Multiple independent processors execute simultaneously on different units of program. When they do on different units of program, this will be the situation. And logical concurrency. Logical concurrency is another type. It is made that multiple processors simultaneously executing on the single unit or single block of a program, guys. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So you may ask me that what is the importance of concurrency? So it involves a new way to describe, to design a software that can be very useful for many real world situations involving concurrency. So concurrency, we can say that it is also a type of sharing of data in between the different processors. So multiprocessing computers capable of physical concurrency are now widely used. So we can say the live example as traffic signals and shared food, guys. That is what the indirect meaning. So they will be shared in between things, right? So traffic signals. If there is a pole in a junction with four roaded junction, so then the four roads are using that single traffic signal and the four roads are working concurrently, right? So that's how the concurrency works, guys. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through tasks. So we'll be completing this subprogram level also here only. So introduction to subprogram level concurrency. A subprogram refers to the complex structure that is nothing but a block of code, guys. Subprogram is nothing but fine. So basically in programming language that can perform some special task for the main program. So in the next tutorial, we'll be repeating this also and we'll be going through tasks. Thank you. Thanks for watching.